polar bear wave? No? Well, let me tell you. Just enough to break the ice. Hi, my name is Nitra. Well, now that I have your attention, welcome to Music from Mother Nature Night. We would like to thank the Coast Salish people for inviting us here to share with you our amazing and inspiring one-hour performance. Our artists include Karina Keeling, Emily Malloy, Holly Arnden, and Kevin. Right. But before that, we have a few speakers, one of whom may actually organize this event, Jay Peachy, followed by Kelly White, director of Stories from the Salish Seas. And last, but definitely not least, Martin Sparrow, a very talented carver, who was actually responsible for some of the carvings on the stage. Well, without further ado, we would like to present to you Music from Mother Nature tonight. Enjoy.
Everyone has a gift of creativity and talent and opportunity and privilege. And so, I'm blessed to actually be here on the mic to be able to speak for all the creative people that are contributing to the show. So I'm like a custodian of the digital talking stick. So we're gonna play a quick video and then we'll have a Indigenous opening with Kelly White here, who she's like auntie, grandma, sister, playmate, creative, fun hostess and producer, and so she's gonna say some words from the heart about Indigenous people, and then we'll have our musicians. We have a great talent, a pool of talent, of creative healers. These are really compassionate people. I know them as activists on the front lines of environmental movements. So we'll get the video started, which is a compilation of a number of programs that we produce. We produce various programming that's creative, but has an educational, very progressive narrative to it. And we have 8 time slots on Shaw TV at Channel 4, and also we'll be broadcasting on Novus, which is another community channel. And that gives us the opportunity to express message kind of free of corporate influence. But we're artists, we like to be free and have our voice, and that comes with its own risks, and people not necessarily understand it, but we stand and defend it as our own truth. And we're not trying to bully anybody into an ideology, but just, you know, show our way. So Gregor Yon, who's up in the booth there, put this together. So give it up for Gregor and the video crew who've put a number of these projects together, and then we'll give it to Kelly.
I reached out to the community to see who would be interested in giving back, and it was unanimous.
Azimuth on Sound Therapy Radio.
the stories from Salish Seas, where we will bring you on a journey, West Coast Indigenous perspective. We will explore arts, culture, and politics from grassroots as well as community perspectives.
We've been here for thousands of years, and I know a lot of people come from Europe and other countries, and they say, oh, the history there is so rich. Well, they're not celebrating our history. They're bringing a little bit of European history over here and celebrating colonial holidays.
The stories from Salish Seas, where we will bring you West Coast Indigenous perspective.
With the crime rate on a steady decline, Canada could be seen as a very safe place.
A policy enforcement officer, that's what the police are, the RCMP. They're actually policy enforcement officers.
You know, the peace officer, policy officer thing, I think a lot of people might find that confusing. You felt like maybe your taxes were not being utilized properly?
Yeah, like okay. It's not really contributing to society. Officer is, if they swear an oath, to serve and protect, and that's not what they seem to be doing, and that's why we want to make a change.
All right, I'll tell you a story of how I, Eagle, became bald.
What was that?
I said bald.
Now this should be good.
I see tons of jellyfish and all of them buried. Sardines are running underwater. It's almost like paddling over a river of silver.
Like, you know, we've had all different types of footage. There's nature scenery, there's the interpersonality, the technical repair, engineering. You know, to say it's just a paddle trip is underselling it.
I totally enjoyed myself, yeah. Wonderful people, beautiful, beautiful place, very special. And I learned how to kayak.
Hi, my name is Wildy Salmon. I'm a lost fish. As part of my natural journey, I return to my place of birth, known as my watershed. In my latest journey back to what I thought was my spawning ground, I come across this big city with tall buildings, roads, and cars. Populated by creatures that they call humans. It's all kind of foreign to me. On my journey home, I get to know these humans and what they're all about. So perhaps they can even help me find my home watershed.
My suggestion, first and foremost, is to never give up hope. The fish have lessons to teach us. And just because human beings are constantly trying to one-up the fish with our egos and think that we are somehow better than the rest of the species, to continue representing the magic and the strength that fish have. Because after all, we know that fish, year after year, regardless what people throw at them and the kinds of things that we do through our habitat, are very capable to continue on with their species, overcome large obstacles and barriers, and as a result, they're a huge metaphor for what people should also be doing for the environment, and that's overcoming obstacles and barriers.
Being that I'm almost human, my head got so big with all those platitudes. Thank you.
No worries. Yes, thank you.
GMO salmon eggs are raised in PEI. They're sent down to Central America where they're growing, and then they're selling the fish. Bad deal. Another very important thing.
Actually, I think it's virtual sand dollars. With, you know, they get to buy a, you know, 20-foot by 10-foot condo downtown somewhere where the air sucks and spend the rest of their life paying off a mortgage to a bank.
That's like close containment.
There is a similarity there. Geez, would that be Would that be good or bad for me as a human?
Well, I think they're getting the same feed as the fish farms. It's just in a different form and nicer packaging with good marketing and promotion by centralized mass market media authorities.
He's a very busy fish type man, and he's got a lot of good things that he's campaigning for, but he needs the public opinion on his side. So vote for Will.
Vote for Will.
Help him legislate that bill.
I gotta find my watershed. That's the story. I'm lost. Wildy Salmon, we got the Wildy Salmon Community TV show. So how did it go in there?
It went really well. We had a standing room only crowd, lots of great questions. It was great. We got lots to follow up on.
I have a question. There's a rumor that the mayor has been smoking salmon. Can you...
He did confess to that.
He did? True. Oh, he did. Okay. Is there a video? Is there any details you can...
I don't have anything other than the fact that he has confessed to smoking salmon.
Did he have a permit, or like what was it, cold smoked or dried? When do you have it?
You know, I don't know that we've done that follow-up work yet.
You know, we'll be tracking him down.
I'm
right?
I'm sure you will.
We did a request, and we didn't get any response.
Okay, well, I'll let him know that you're following up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let him know it's a fish like character. Will D. Salmon.
Will D. Salmon.
Yeah. Shaw right. On 1 a.m. So if he's up that late reading council minutes, Channel 4.
All right, I'll let him know.
All right, thanks.
Up.
Yeah, fish, that's a salmon arm. Salmon arm, yeah. Thank you, Heather. Zing!
Join us on Sunday at 1 a.m. where you can find another episode of The Wildy Salmon Show.
And weekdays for Sound Therapy Arts TV with Rika Jasper. Hope you enjoyed the show.
Thanks for joining us.
All right, we have our host from Musqueam, and also Kelly White, maybe you want to join us up on stage here. Martin Sparrow is Musqueam creative chief, I'd say. He's carved this beautiful Chinook, so he has many words of wisdom, so.
Hi, I'm Martin Sparrow, I'm from Musqueam. I kind of feel for what Jay's been doing, you know, because we lost so much of ourself. We're not real anymore, you know, our people, it's all about, you know, I don't believe in chief and councils, you know, and I said that to that little Sean guy. We lost so much about, you know, who we are, you know, and my brothers and sisters are going to church right now, and they brought me there, you know, and I'm singing gospel songs too. I didn't think I would be doing, but it took me a long time to be proud of who I was. Now I have to work on my children to be proud of who they are, and my grandchildren to be proud of who they are, because they're going to see their grandfather all over the place doing these political things. But I always pray about what I'm doing, and, you know, when Jay asked me to come here, and, you know, he told me he was bringing my carvings, you know, and... You know, because it took me a long time to be proud of what I was doing, and I never even thought I was good even when I did that, you know, and I'm sitting there, hey, how come you never think that you're worthy, you know, when I did that, you know, and I'm sitting there, yeah, I am a good person, you know, because, we have true people down there right now, and the ones who are at those burial sites, we have to get rid of the ones that are in there now. They're not very, I've been straight, you know, for 29 years, and I don't see that in my own community. You know, when I want to be proud of, I am proud of what I'm doing. And I just got to keep on passing it down to the next generations. If we're going to be putting a carving shed up, we're going to be building traveling canoes, we're going to tell them how to be, you know, how to be Native. To be proud to be on that boat, to be proud to have a drum, you know, because this guy, his name is Eli, made these drums. These ones are made out of goat. And he had some of my carving, Eli's carving tools that he made. And so I think we just got to keep on supporting the good works that are happening out in the cities with all these grassroots people. It's not going to happen with our own chief and councils around Canada. It's not going to happen that way. We have to get back to being who we are. And that takes a lot of work to understand who you are. It takes a lot of work. And I'm not finished, and I still got a lot of work to do on myself. So when I sing a song, you know, and I think it was at that Hobie, didn't they call it Hobie? And I'm sitting there, I gotta watch the songs that I sing. I said, they're getting mad at me at home. So I'll sing this song, and like my grandfather and my father wasn't happy, you know, with what was going on in our community with chief and council. He's gone now. So the rest of the family has to carry it out and start being proud of being Musqueam. The ones that are running our communities right now, they're not strong Musqueam. You know, even though that she's from Musqueam, you know, we have to first keep on bringing in the strong people because they don't live in our reserve. They're all living out there, the ones with education. And so I'll let you. You want to sing a few words?
Oh, you could do some.
Sing a song.
Welcome.
Okay. Welcome.
Ho, 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 ho. People seen it in me as a child, that I was a leader. So that's why I'm here, and I think it time's up, and thank you for having me here. And so all my relations, amen.
In the highest of the honor, we thank you for the privilege of sharing Mother Earth's celebration with you all. And ladies and gentlemen, and we thank Jay Peachy and the crew for putting the show together tonight. And mostly, we thank you for the honor of your time sharing with us this evening. You won't be the same.
All right, thank you, Martin and Kelly. Martin and Kelly are very strong spirits, and I take a lot of education from them. And I'd like to also now introduce Karina Keeling and Emily Malloy. Very beautiful spirits in many aspects, and share their wisdom and music. And as they're getting set up here, I'd just like to thank them for coming and always sharing their gift. And Karina just launched a new CD, and it's going to be outside, so take it away, guys.
Sure. Thank you, Jay. Thank you, Jay. My name is Karina Keeling. This is Emily Malloy. We are both singer-songwriters, and I'm bringing some of my music, and Emily's bringing him some of her music, but Emily's actually the first person that I met when I moved to Coast Salish territory, and we've been playing music together for a long time, so we thought we'd take this opportunity to share the stage with each other. We're going to be passing the instrument back and forth a little bit. And so, of course, as always, really, really humbled and grateful to be here on Coast Salish territory. Thank you to the Tsleil-Waututh, the Chmosquam, and the Squamish people for allowing me to be here and do what I love to do more than anything else in the world in this one of the most beautiful places I've ever been in the world. It's I'm constantly humbled. This first song that I'm going to sing, I usually sing it a little further into the set, so it feels a little intimidating to speak about it so early when I've just met you all. Hello. But this is a song that I wrote just before I moved into one of the deepest, darkest times of my adult life. And this is this experience that we're having here together is about Mother Nature, but it's also about mental health. And I think they're deeply connected. Our relationship to those two are deeply connected. And I'm not going to tell you the whole story, but ultimately, this deep heartbreak that I experienced was when I started to understand and really feel in my body that this idea of oppression of the land and of Mother Earth, the systems and the structures that allow us to treat her the way that we have been treating her, are exactly the same and are mirrored in the way that we treat our women, and actually allowed that experience into my body for the first time and actually felt that violence. And this song came to me at 2:30 in the morning, in the middle of the night, and woke me up out of my sleep and demanded to be written, and then became very depressed shortly after that. And this song really saved my life, because my roommates, my sister, would crawl into bed beside me and whisper the words of this song that I had written into my ear. And it was one of the things that kept me going in that really dark time in my life. So this is a song called Dig Deep, and I'm excited to share it with you.
You gotta know now that this is your time.
just let it come through. Invite the worship for the goddess you are and the courage that you're bringing. You gotta know you're a gift from the stars. Have faith.
Thank you. I'm good at a lot of things in this world, but promoting myself is not one of them. So I often all the shows that I've played so far since I released this album, I've forgotten to tell people about it.
It's really awesome. I have a copy actually in my purse. I carry it around with me all the time.
It's been a long time coming. I've been writing music for about 10 years and saying that I've been going to release an album for about 7 now, I guess. And I have a background in environmental justice and social justice, and there was always this idea that I wanted to release this album, I wanted to make this music, but there was just no time because there was work to do. And I really, through the reflection of a lot of amazing people and just a lot of lessons and gifts in my life, I've come to understand that this is my work, and the impact that I can make in the world is so much stronger when I'm actually doing what I really love to do and I'm really lit up by doing. And I wish that for everyone in the world. And I used to feel like, you know, making music was this selfish thing to do. And I'm finally starting to understand that it's selfish not to. So
it is. That's for all of your gifts.
Yeah.
Don't hide.
So thank you for being here and bearing witness to something that lights me up and for hopefully enjoying it as well. This is a song that's about letting go, and it's called Hollow Wooden Box. So, you told me to tell them about the album, and then I didn't. It's called...
You told us about how you never tell us about the album.
It's called Say Yes. It was released last week on the 11th of June, and it's available in the lobby. It's also available on my website and a bunch of other places. So if you just look up my name on my website, it's karinakeeling.ca, and they're also available in the lobby and everywhere that you can buy them. They're available on a sliding scale. I really want my... I wrote this music so that it would be heard. And I want to share it with as many people as I can. So if anyone feels really connected to the music and really called to the music and doesn't have the means to buy a CD, send me an email or go on my website and send me a message there, and I'll make sure that you get it.
Hi, everybody. My name is Emily Malloy. When Karina and I first started singing songs together, we came up with a ridiculous name for our band.
Which was just the two of us.
Which is just the two of us. And we both have songs. Hers is Hollow Wooden Box, and mine is called Thistle Box. So we decided to call... It was a set. In the set, within the set, it was two hollow wooden boxes. So we called ourselves Box Set for a good, 5 years. We don't call ourselves that anymore, but I thought I would share that story. Because I just realized that
we're playing the Box Set.
The Box Set.
The
today.
Box Set set.
There you go. That just... Yeah. So this song is called Thistle Box. Thank God for photographs of mine. I cannot remember so many things. No, I don't look that old, but the road makes you eyes beyond what wrinkles bring. Stick out your thumb a little further, kid, I don't think they can see it. You're gonna get there, you have to let them see that you believe it.
Tacos for a dollar in El Tango, and one day the youngest will inherit secret recipes for his niños. The elephant will bless you if you look into his eyes and rub his trunk. The kind Indian man will smile, shake your hand and say, that's good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, and love and gratitude for your time and energy. Thank you, Jay Peachy, for having us here.
Thank you, everyone.
Gotcha. Give it up for Karina and Emily. All right, we're going to do a quick break. We've got Silent Auction, and we have Janice Jacinto, who's kind of like a creative sister of mine and really has struggled with her own mental health and is very expressive about it. So feel free to have a conversation with her now or after. But come back, and then we have Holly and Kevin coming to perform. So stay tuned for that. Be right back, everybody.
Oh, look, it's Will D. Salmon.
Will
D. Silver Salmon.
Will! What a profile.
The best profile in the ocean.
So what's going on here?
We're just hanging around waiting for the water levels so we can spawn.
Yep, that's it.
Check.
Yeah.
Well, thanks everybody for coming. My name's Will. I can see you right here. I've been watching you guys eat my cousins for years and years. Oh my gosh. Well, just for the halibut, I'm going to point to Martin's art. And also, Hope the Whale is here.
Yeah, Hope the Whale.
Thank you to Amy and crew from Lead Now. And we have Holly and Kevin, everybody. Give it up. The stage is yours.
Thank you, Will.
And to kick things off on a great note, here's a song about melting glaciers.
Na 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 Thank you.
Cheers. So that song is dedicated to doing as much research as possible to understand what happened and is there something we can be doing to bring our salmon back. And the thing we keep doing is writing songs. And this next one was co-written with Roy Henry Vickers, the wonderful artist. And it's called I.O. And I.O. is a word that you'll hear in coastal First Nations up and down the coast, is what Roy told us, from Haida Gwaii to the west coast to the southern Salish Sea here. And it, and when people go out to the fishing grounds and they see a salmon leap, they call, I.O. I.O.
That would signify where the school was, and they would, all the boats would head that direction.
Wildy, there he is. Okay, so people, we would like you to sing with us. It's an echo part, and every time we sing,
I-O.
I-O, you sing I-O, and make the salmon leap with your hand, right? Go I-O, yeah, like that, okay.
Exactly.
Sockeye flash and dance in the sun. I-O,
I-O.
Fishermen watch and holler as one. I-O,
I-O.
Thinking of days in summers gone by. I-O,
I-O.
Missing the return of many sockeye. I-O,
I-O.
1900s, my family fished in Guayanas. I go into the beach in a rowboat and come to some little no-name creek. Take off my shoes and walk in the water so I could feel those fish swimming between my legs, hitting my feet, and slapping against my ankles. Out on the bay, the gill netters were drifting along with their nets on a set. Oh, those were the days. And now I'm the elder, thinking about the way it was. And I know there's a way we can bring those days back again.
Thank you.
Well, okay, so we were thinking we'd like to do a song together with Karina and Emily. Can you welcome them back to the stage?
Once again, thanks for having us, you guys, and thank you all you wonderful people for coming out and putting butts in some seats and supporting a great cause.
Music for Mother Nature.
Music for
Here
Mother
we
Nature.
Are. Okay.
All aspects of Mother Nature. Especially the rain, the life-giving rain.
Someone told me long ago, there's a calm before the storm, and I know it's been coming for some time. When it's over, so they say, it'll rain a sunny day, and I know, oh, shining down like water. We'll be right back.
still forever on it goes. Through the surf, fast and slow. And I know it can't stop, I wonder, yeah. Woo! And I want to know, have you ever seen the rain? I want to know, have you ever seen the rain? Coming down, sunny day.
Thank you. Holly Arnson. I'm Kevin Wright.
Hi, I'm Emily Malloy.
And
thanks for listening.
Karina Keeling, thank you.
And thank you all, thanks, everyone.
That has been Music from Mother Nature Night, Part 1. We hope you enjoyed. Please stay tuned for Part 2. We would also like to inform you that on June 13th, 2015, there will be Music from Mother Nature Night. As well as on September 25th to the 27th, there will be a Burrard Inlet Fish Fest. We really hope you enjoyed. Bye.